Hi everyone, it's composer, producer, writer Danny Shirt. It's May 1st, 2021, May Day, International Workers' Day. And this is the history of May Day. My Stan movie musical comes out today in the United States on VOD, May 18th in Canada. There's links in the description below. So what's the difference between May Day, Labor Day, International Workers' Day? I'll explain all those and the history of the day right now. The first version of the celebration of May Day go back to prehistoric times. May 1st in the Northern Hemisphere usually marks the coming of the spring, unless you're in Winnipeg, Canada, where I am. The day's festivities were a plea to the gods for fertility in the coming crop year, and marked with a dance around a live tree. In recent centuries, the celebration morphed into the Maypole celebration on May 1st, where a pole, not a live tree, was set up in the town center and an elaborate dance with ribbons takes place. May Day is still marked by Maypole dancing in many places across the world. But then the latter half of the 19th century, the 1860s to the 1880s, was a time of unprecedented labor unrest in the United States in particular. And in Chicago, on May 4th, 1886, an otherwise peaceful crowd seeking an 8-hour workday was met with violence, and the resulting injuries and death became known as the Haymarket Affair. Haymarket was the galvanizing reason for May Day morphing into a day of labor protest. So 4 years after Haymarket, on May 1st, 1890, the first International Workers' Day was celebrated, and May Day had fully morphed into a day of recognition of and protest for labor rights. And to this day, most places in the world celebrate May 1st as International Workers' Day, some calling it Labor Day. But then, during the course of the 20th century, the following split occurred. In Canada, the United States, and Australia, Labor Day did a bit of a migration. In those three countries, Labor Day is celebrated on the first Monday in September, and the September long weekend, or the Labor Day long weekend, is the traditional end of summer. The reason for Labor Day's migration into September was largely political. During the course of the 20th century, May Day on May 1st came to be associated with socialism and communism, and those on the right of the labor movement sought to disassociate with that interpretation of May Day. This interpretation of Labor Day is one where labor and employers get along and agree to have a day off at the end of the summer, hence the September Labor Day. This more cooperative vision of Labor Day in September is distinct from the protest-oriented origins of May Day and the Haymarket Affair. So what this means to workers in North America, at least, is that there are 2 days on which labor rights can be recognized, May Day and Labor Day. And in the case of the Stan movie musical, we specifically chose to release it on VOD in the United States on International Workers' Day. The story is born in protest, the 1919 Winnipeg General Strike. It shows workers fighting for their rights just short decades after Haymarket, and May was the actual month of the start of the Winnipeg General Strike on which the movie is based. So that's the history of May Day. Happy International Workers' Day. Now you go watch the Stan movie musical. You can also get the soundtrack on iTunes. Click like on this video, subscribe to our channel, and see you again. Thanks.